I don't know how many of you listen to what is a really important case that is going on right now. Supreme Court hearing a case on whether or not Joe Biden's COVID vaccine mandate for 84 million employees, 2 out of 3 people employed in the private sector all over the country. If your employer has 100 or more people, you would theoretically be covered by this. I listened to the questioning this morning and I was blown away by the stupidity of Sonia Sotomayor, who famously referred to herself as a wise Latina. She was not wise in her questioning of the lawyers in today's oral arguments. In particular, I'm going to pick on her and then I'm going to go over to Stephen Breyer. She said things that are 100,000,000,000% factually inaccurate. She said there were 100,000 kids with serious cases of COVID right now. It's not remotely true. There are right now only 116,000 people nationwide hospitalized with COVID of all ages, and the vast majority of them are elderly if they have serious cases or obese. Hardly any of them are children. And the vast majority, honestly, of those 116,000 people, as even Fauci himself has acknowledged, and Governor Kathy Hochul of New York, not exactly founts of regular factual information, they have acknowledged that there is a big difference between people who are hospitalized with COVID and hospitalized because of COVID. In other words, many people go in, let's say you're going in for a knee replacement. You might test positive for COVID. You count as a COVID hospitalization, even though you didn't go to the hospital for COVID at all. You may be hospitalized because you're a pregnant mom who is about to give birth. They will test you for COVID. You would test positive for COVID and be counted as a COVID hospitalization, even though the only reason you're testing positive is because you're there to give birth and you otherwise have no idea that you would have COVID. This matters because how can you build a factually reliable opinion on COVID vaccine mandates when you are Judge Sonia Sotomayor and you are spreading a falsehood about 100,000 kids being hospitalized and or having severe cases of COVID right now? It's a lie. It is a 100,000,000,000% lie. It is a factual inaccuracy. Honestly, the Supreme Court should fix this and issue a correction after the oral arguments. Also, she said, Judge Sonia Sotomayor did, among other idiocy, she said that Omicron was just as dangerous as Delta. It's not true. It's not remotely true. So far, the Omicron variant of Delta is a fraction as dangerous as Delta. This is widely discussed, widely understood by people all over the country. This is an unbelievable failure that a Supreme Court justice could believe that. It was not just that, by the way. Justice Stephen Breyer said, it's important to get this COVID vaccine mandate in place because right now there are around 750,000 cases a day. And if the vaccine mandate were allowed to exist, Judge Breyer said that we would immediately see those 750,000 cases a day cease to exist, which is a fundamental misunderstanding, one, of how long the vaccine process is, right? And two, 95% of people ages 65 and up are already vaccinated, at least with one shot. 86% of people 18 and up are already vaccinated, at least with one shot. The vaccine is not ending COVID. In fact, we are setting all-time record highs, despite the fact that the vast majority of the American public has listened to the Biden administration and Dr. Fauci and gone and gotten their vaccine. This is a big story because the left wing of the court believes things that are fundamentally untrue. And I would love to know behind the scenes, how does this happen? How does Sonia Sotomayor get that much wrong? How does Justice Breyer get this much wrong? Let me give you a little story. When your boy was back in law school, I had a con law professor named Rebecca Brown, very smart, former Supreme Court clerk. For those of you not familiar with how Supreme Court clerkships work, every judge gets 4 Supreme Court clerks every year. There are only 36 of them. Those jobs are the most plum appointments for any law student who hopes to one day be a high-level appellate court judge. If you love the law and you want to be a judge one day, this is the pathway to that. It's also a pathway to teaching in law school, which is an incredible job for lots of people to be able to get. So they're highly sought after, highly desirable, very difficult to get. Rebecca Brown was my law school professor, among others, in con law at Vanderbilt University. She told me a story. I believe she was a clerk for Judge Souter. But she said one of the challenges of the Supreme Court, and I was thinking about this as I listened to the oral arguments, is many justices are not aware of what the larger universe is like. They are very cloistered. They are much older than typical. And she used an example. She said one night they were working late on cases, and they decided to order pizza. And a bunch of the justices had no idea that you could just order a pizza and they would bring it to your house. They legitimately had not ever ordered pizza in their life. They didn't understand it. She said, Judge Souter, as the law clerks were sitting and eating pizza, working late night at the Supreme Court, as the law clerks were sitting there working, Judge Souter came in and he said, oh, what are you guys eating? And he stopped and he looked at the pizza and he said, what's on top of the pizza there? And she walked over and she looked and she said, the pizza. He said, are those tomatoes? And she said, no, Justice Souter, those are pepperonis. And Justice Souter had no idea that pepperoni pizza existed. And her analogy was there, this is a judge who is deciding the overwhelming law of the land, and he doesn't even know that a pepperoni pizza exists. So it's an amazing analogy and story, and it contextualizes at times how out of touch many justices are. And I was thinking about that because the clerks of Justice Sonia Sotomayor and of Stephen Breyer and of Elena Kagan as well have completely failed to prepare them. Now, I don't know if they didn't read their briefing materials. I don't know if they were totally unaware of what the facts of COVID actually are. But as a lawyer, I was embarrassed to hear the questions that Sonia Sotomayor was asking. As a lawyer, I was embarrassed to hear the questions that Stephen Breyer was asking. There are all sorts of legal rationales that you can accept. If you want to give the executive branch expansive authority to allow them to regulate every business in America with over 100 employees under OSHA, you can find the textual reason to do so. Okay, I disagree with it. If I were on the Supreme Court right now, I would find that to be an overreaching, expansive authority. I would look at what the Senate did when the Senate said by a 52-48 vote, they don't agree with the Biden vaccine mandate. I think it is overly expansive given the scope of OSHA power. I would put this in a similar vein as the CDC's attempt to extend an eviction moratorium. I don't believe it is within the scope of their power. I think the legislative branch would have to act in concert with the executive branch in order for this regulatory agency, OSHA, to be able to have the authority to do this. But there is a method by which you can argue that should occur. But when your factual basis is as wrong as Breyer, Kagan, and in particular Justice Sonia Sotomayor, it is impossible for me to believe that the foundation of your legal logic is sound when your facts are broken. To me, this was an embarrassing day for the left wing of the Supreme Court. I believe that the overall vaccine mandate of Joe Biden is going to be struck down. I hope that the court is going to have the testicular fortitude to do so behind Kavanaugh, Gorsuch, Amy Coney Barrett, John Roberts, and Alito. I hope that they are going to be brave enough to actually stand up to, and Kavanaugh, all of this absurdity. But we know there are three votes on the left wing of the court basically to support Joe Biden saying or doing anything. And that's a little bit scary because the Constitution should stand for principle over party. And right now it doesn't sound like it is.